Spider Big, worst conversonic team ever did. Hello everyone, it's RJ UK here. Joining me is Blake Draco. Say hello, Blake.
Hello everyone.
We'll be with you very shortly. For now, his sealed ground from Sonic Riders Zero Gravity. We'll be right back. It's great. You know what was brilliant? I just saw pop up in the Sonic Stadium chat. Wait, AUK is here? Wow. Newsflash, he's here every goddamn Sunday. Absolute monumental fail. Sorry, Alex.
If you don't know me by now, you ain't never ever gonna know me.
The last 30 weeks. The last 4 or 5 years.
At some point I wasn't here. Wow. Well, we'll move on to that.
The only point was my wedding. Am I not? Is it that bad that I'm not allowed to to go somewhere other than be here?
That's just bad.
I might not be here for 2 weeks' time, depends on how things go. So, that'll be interesting. Because it's the AUK scene to play. I'm serenading Alex. But yeah, at the beginning of the show we had the Apollo 440 Spider-Man theme remix with added jingle bits from us at this end, because every single piece of music can be easily improved by simply going
ROCKET!
That's the theory anyway. It makes sense to me. Seriously.
He's got a massive red.
Fail.
I keep messing up the wrong. All makes sense. Yeah.
You.
So let's go through people here, because I don't know what's happened to Radio Zega. Bobby Light points out you had a week break when you were engaged. Yeah, I know. What did that get me? Dreadnought has a request, which is, Kev, say suck on my and play Rocket. But then I should technically be able to then do that with some Sonic Rush, and then that, and then I would have suck on my Rocket. Suck on my drill. There are many things you can do with this, you know.
Spire's sapping my
drill!
It's awesome, you know. Suck my
laser!
See? I beat Hogfather to it. There we go. Yeah. The best thing about Sonic is clearly his
spike!
There we go. SJ says wrong is the only funny part of Superman Returns. Well, yes. But in fairness, it wasn't a comedy. Or at least it wasn't deliberately a comedy. So, that's not... Suck on my werehog, says Hogfather. Yeah, I hang far too much from that sound deck. Oh yes, we certainly are.
Boy!
See? We could just go on forever, this entire show, actually. Just doing that. It'd be great. Yeah, you just have that. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the soundboard show. No, it's not. Radio Sega's chat, who is somewhat dead.
People show up.
People show up, don't worry. We got Trekky, the Mellotron, SJ, Silver Sonic, Shadow of a Doubt, who is praising. Freezing, presumably. What now? There we go. I knew I had it somewhere. Well, since he's frozen, you'll have this in the background instead. Okay. This is Suck on My Sonic Hero! No, I think you'll find the answer. The answer is suck on my awesome power of T-Rex. I have to celebrate you, baby. Yeah. I have to praise you like that. It's clear it was a good day. Right, we've got Ryo Nakagi also, RW Devora, Retrix MTels, who is away! Miles Prower, who is not away. Ink Empires, Inigo Bonato, D'Artagnan, Cover the Best, Bro Crusher, Blitz Chris, Sub Geezer, who's on Sonic, Sega Sonic Radio and Radio Sega at the same time, and Underscore Spondy. Over on the somewhat more active version, is the following. Voice, VJ, Turbo, Tricky, the Molotron, T-Bird, who did a fantastic show, which I'm sure was awesome. Then Sparkle, Sonic AD. So I was like, no, I only heard the last bit. I was having a difficulty getting in. Apparently, team was having trouble. Sparkle, Sonic AD, Silver Sonic, Shadza. Shadza! Triple Zone 4, Retrix. Reeby the Fox, the main, Lars Prower, Johnny, and the SMB hates them. Aww, the Orbit. You say your name was Ken Below. Hulk Lava, Fox Boy, who is also away. Is Fox Boy away with M-Tails, I wonder? Star Wars rumors. Farmer Alchemist is there again. Still trying to turn those cows into gold. Empires is in there. I knew Gabinato. Dreadnox has finally remembered he's got a radio station as joined us. Who knows? He'll eventually remember he's got a radio show. If you actually wait. D'Artagnan, Darkspeed, Dark Over. I think it's supposed to be Dark Overlord, but it's Dark Overawed instead. Cobra the Best, Blondie Light. As opposed to Debbie Harry Heavy. Alex DeBeta, who've already mentioned. Underscore Spondy, who we've also already mentioned. MK Blitz Chris, the magnificently sexy Rory. I'm still thinking of Farmer. Where is he? Hey, Rory. Roars. Yeah, Chan-Bot. Then Chan-Bot. And a master race of spiders. Because that's what this show is all about. It's all about the master race of spiders. A lot of us don't remember who I am. No. I'm afraid not. Remind me. There are many, 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 many people that I know of by name, but please remind me, seriously. I've not come across Blondie for a while, that name, so please remind me. Apologies, I don't recall you, but carrying on. But like Hugs, AK and Blake, we got Hugs. I normally get pelted with stones, so that's the Betty's. Apparently there's Kitties involved as well. Maybe Blondie Light is Echo Hawk.
If you wonder that.
If you wonder where she is, so do we.
She's in the same place she is every kind of week, nearly.
For a special sort of Pinky and Becky show. What are we doing tonight, Brain? Same thing we do every night, Pinky. And every day. And every night. Oh no, every day is sleep, but every night is the thing that Jay is currently waggling around for added sound effects. Do it again. It's a box of cereal. No, it's World of Warcraft.
I prefer a box of cereal.
Which is different because it's a cereal disappointment. apart from that, yeah, it's kind of crazy. turn off the old music. Because back in the day, when we didn't do this, it used to be a lot easier to hear us. Let the action begin. When, you know, it came round to actually having the show.
I did
press stop, and it's still intending to play. So it really shouldn't. Manual. But yes, today is all about the master race of spiders. To be said in the proper way, a master race of spiders. Because for some reason we've got into our heads about the Lost in Space movie, which actually tenuous link, because Apollo 440 did the Spider-Man remix at the beginning of the show, and they did the main theme for the Lost in Space movie. Perhaps we'll have that later. Confusingly, it was released at exactly the same time as the Lighthouse Family, if you remember them, released a song called Lost in Space, which has nothing to do with the film. But it was released at the same time as the movie and the main theme.
And it did well?
It did very well, actually. it did better than the movie. Because everyone thought it was to do with the movie, and it wasn't. I wonder what happened to the Lighthouse Family. Living in a lighthouse, presumably. Why aren't they using the Pingers sound effect? Maybe due to the fact that the Pingers sound effect sucks. It sucks Pingers and rockets and drills and doctors and ham and sentries and baloney and all the wonderful things that are on this sound effects board and Yoshi's. There you go.
Many wonderful things.
Well, it says kitties again.
Everyone likes
the kitties. We've been having a bit of a laugh, actually, in the Sonic Stadium chat. Partly due to the fact that the Radio Sonic chat's so dead. But there were some interesting things that T-Bird inadvertently came up with a line which we took to... We took to him having the best lines ever for chat up lines. I can't find it now. Where is it? Where's it gone? There we go. There's I live on the proton rich side of the valley of stability, because that's his chat up line. It works. Also, I'm told.
It needs to be tested. Important. It's gone through rigorous testing anyway. So.
It's gone through rigorous testing. Yeah. rigorous testing. You know. Do you want your value of stability proton rich? It makes sense to me. Also, apparently, Vija is busy tasting port. Because everyone's port. All the sailors say that Vija's port is a storm, or something. To that effect. Rather disturbingly, he then went on to say, regarding his port, something terrible after. Tastes kind of fruity with a slight metallic aftertaste. So, at this point, we're getting too much information, I think. Has the chat room died? Have we died?
No, we haven't died.
Just nobody's said anything for the past however long. Seems kind of weird. Oi, shut up.
The whole chat room is...
are they finally run out of conversation to have?
The master race spiders
has eaten them. This is the problem. But anyway, hello, welcome to the show. We're going to discuss a few things this week. Well, first up, well, I think we already established earlier yesterday that an addition to the Sonic Rex Council of Evil would be Dr. Smith. But did we specify if it was like just Dr. Smith or Spider Dr. Smith? Because, you know, there's differences.
There's differences, but Dr. Smith would have turned into Spider Dr. Smith anyway.
That's true. So you get one, you get both, technically.
Yeah.
And you get the egg sacs as well.
Egg-sacs containing...
A master race of spiders, I do believe.
Someone's texting you.
Someone's texting me, which means something's gone wrong. Hideously wrong. What else has been going on this week?
Well, you've
Pumped
been playing. You've been playing Vanquish. That's what I don't know. That's a week, like since Friday.
Ah, the reason why is that there's been a net split on the chat room.
Oh.
So we need to rejoin apparently. So that's why it's been silent. Here's me thinking that people had finally learned to shut up, but I was rudely mistaken.
Hmm.
So we got to reconnect now. Joy of joys, joy of joys. Net split. Doof, 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 doof. I've got some illegal characters in my character. Oh, shut up.
No, but you still join anyway, don't worry.
There we go. Ram the Dragon has joined in the meantime.
Mm.
She is several miles away. Hurrah. Well, something. Oh, hi. Hey, okay, we didn't even notice you last time. Ionigonato advertises the fact.
Starting again.
Ionigonato is back from, you know, making out of a sponge. I'm not talking like a normal sponge, I'm talking like the ones you get from under the sea.
Under the sea.
It was either that or get through to the sea cucumber. So it was one of the two. But yes, so well, I'm not sure what's that. Well, I've been playing Vanquish, yes. I played Vanquish over the weekend, which is great. It is awesome.
And you've actually completed it.
I mean, it was only easy, but I need to go back and do sort of normal mode and then on to hard mode, etc. But I've already unlocked. Well, it's great because the mode above the mode above hard is called God Hard. That's pretty awesome.
It's gonna be fun.
Dear, dear.
Hiya.
Yosh. So, yeah, I've been playing that. It's been great fun. More fun than Bayonetta. Not as good music as Bayonetta, but never mind. Can't do everything. Can't have it all. But it was nice to have a set of controls that you could actually master and be fluent. And that was what I loved about. I mean, I love about that because it's just so fluent. And by the end of it, I was like doing dash kicks into twisting slowdown time bashing basically of enemies. It's just really fun when there's like an enemy that completely owns you, and then you finally figure out how to do it, and you just completely toast them as a result.
Sense of achievement, then I guess.
Yeah, I mean there's an enemy called the Unknown, which is just like some imagine like a red core, which then a red core with two very spindly legs, and then sort of scatters along, and then it sort of draws around the a various amount of parts, and then uses them for some electric field as weaponry. Where's the music gone? If you listened earlier, you'd have heard the reason why we're not playing the music. Music comes later. If you want just a music show, then, you know, keep listening in, because the 24/7 stream will be later. I wonder if Renato wants to do random things. I think Renato should really stop.
Stop, but if you can pay her, pay
her. Don't talk to me about work. No, really don't. Actually, that reminds me, I've got something to do later. Obviously, a few things to prepare for next week. Including getting my stuff ready for Japan, among other things.
Yeah. So that will be fun.
One of the last few things I'm doing is the show next week, Halloween show. And this was like, crap.
Fluff.
Fluff. Fluff! He is very quiet, which contrasts with last night, which wasn't very quiet at all. So,
awful atmosphere.
Yeah, if the show was doing big and it happened last week, last night, sorry, then
you heard fireworks.
You'd have heard fireworks, yeah, and all sorts. Tim says, "With AAUK in Japan, I'll steal your spot." No, I will be back. The plan is that I will be back through the door about an hour before the show goes up, so I will still do the show in 2 weeks' time, theoretically. That's how awesome I am. I'll be straight back from Japan and I will do a Red Redux show because I'm a freaking idiot.
Yeah,
pretty much, yeah. So we did that. I think that makes the foolish mistake of saying surely Echo and Blake could cover for you. Yeah, Echo can cover for me. Isn't that right? Okay. Oh, wait. Right, let's have... Ramdang says you'll collapse midway.
In before
I collapse midway. And this would be new... This would be different to my evening's howl, Sophia. Oh, that's some fun. But yeah, we've got a few things next week. Along with sorting out my plan of attack. A few other things as well, which you may find out about down the line. We'll have to see. Yay! Shadow Fox 4 says, I'm currently shaving with scissors because I don't want to leave the chat for a second. You need to get your priorities right. Someone needs to tell AAK not to work too hard. Yeah. Can you replace AUK with Sega? Tell Sega. Sega, adding Sega that AUK should. Dark Overlord, you really need to add in an L. No, I mean, I like shaving. You have to trim with scissors. Actually, I need a new pair of scissors just for that fact, because it seems to have rusted.
Hmm.
I don't know what's happened. No, it's all good. I still miss who Blondie was. Vidra asked if you get the guidebooks okay. Yes, I did. Vidra has been awesome and sent me his guidebooks. The lane has not got a beard left. That's either good news for T or too much information. I'm not sure which one it is. I blame the radioactivity around him. So apparently next week today might be the last of tea time. What's left at this point in time? Because EC Airwaves is off. It's just me and Turbo again, isn't it?
just us
and Blitz Chris. Don't worry, we'll be here, fly the flag, doing all the rest. Vija's birthday, by the way, was this week. So, a big, massive happy birthday to Vija! Tibo says, I don't know, is the Sonic Hour back? Oh, Jesus, you must be joking! But yes, Vija's birthday. And we wish her a happy birthday. We also wish her a happy birthday to the Sonic Stadium itself, which is 10 years old today. Hmm. 10 years. 10 years of, well, a few things, I guess. I don't know. Stuff.
In the beginning, there was...
Because what marvellous things have we had over the years from Sonic Stadium? There was that time when, you know, they disappeared. That was bad. That was a bad thing. I'm just texting it again. Apparently, the Red Wings hotline just gone off. Let me know there will be an Emerald Coast Airways Super Show on the 6th of November. That's good news. No, but in all seriousness, it's not saying that I've got for the community over the years. I've got more than I can do at some stage. And it's a great place to talk to fans of various ages who are very open-minded. So other ones are seriously Silver Sonic. If all you want to do is hear the music, then you know you've got to see it. So it's great. SMB back. We had that blip a year or so ago, and apparently Drenox has something planned for this evening. Super and duper. And he is completely and utterly not something you'd expected for a world owing to the fact that he advertised it.
I think it's quite a major milestone.
Did I tell you this? Awesome. How long did Moogle Cabin go for before it disappeared? I thought Red Bull. Have they overtaken Moogle Cabin? Because I'm not sure. How long has Retro been going for? We've been going for 6. Retro's been going for how long? Somebody tell me how long Retro's been going for. Who is Retro? Anyway, it's great when you get real interaction. No, in some sense, so you got something carrying on later, and it's nothing you what you expect, honestly. Actually, I don't know what it is. But my guess is it's just a video. Do you remember the Sonic short with Eggman doing the dance and melting Sonic's eyes? I think it's just Dread doing that dance. That's what it is. It can't possibly be anything else. So, on that basis, being careful not to exit the whole thing there. Because
we've got a break, I think.
Time for a music break. Until Sonic's left, so I can miss out on the music. So, what music shall we have? Suggestions? Or shall we ask the Master Race of Spiders?
Ask the Master Race of Spiders?
Oh, we'll ask the Master Race of Spiders!
The spiders should know everything.
Spiders do know everything. They're master race spiders. They don't like lesser spiders at all.
They don't like house spiders.
They don't like house spiders, no. They much prefer Holby City spiders. Well, let's have some Crush 40, which won't cost you a dime, and Fire Woman, which has nothing to do with Sonic, but it is to do with Crush 40. It's off the Supersonic Songs album. Let's have that. And we'll follow that up with something classic-y Sonic. I'll be there soon. Okay. Be back soon, guys. Yeah. So do you want to hear something funny? I was looking up things for Summer of Sonic videos on YouTube, and I came across another video using the ripped sound effects from Radio Redux.
Yeah.
Maybe it was Roger Craig Smith's voice. And it says, hey, it's like Sega of America employee of Danger UK. And it's like, yeah, well done. Well done. You've got that completely 100% accurate. Is that the UK? It's actually supposed to be US, but the physics is wrong, so it comes out as a K. We have had some questions. We could do some more questions. More questions, particularly about the spiders. All the spiders will get you. But yes, we had Crush 40 with Fire Woman. And then we had Nespa and Skorusha with Emerald Knights. The Looking Up remix from Hedgehog Heaven. You have a clocked remix project. Yeah. So, we do indeed have questions. I'm going to go quickly first. Oh, here's some news that I didn't actually realise. Sonic Cage and Dynamite have officially announced that they're dead in basically all but name. And it's basically just an archive now, and they're going to cut down costs and just make it an archive. In fairness, Cage Dome hasn't really been there for like 2 years. They were very much there at Summer of Sonic 08, although they did appear to be in their own little world. We didn't seem to take in the fact that they were supposed to be doing stuff. All they were doing was like sitting there playing games. But no, because apparently KJM has officially died, so that's sad news. Sad community-based news. It does, however, mean, you know, one little thing. Namely, that means that we are the only surviving third-generation Sonic website! Woo! We win! For a process of elimination, we have won. We have won to internet.
Natural selection.
it's brilliant. I need the extra life thing for the We win. There we go. It's almost as if the community is just like polarizing various places. But yeah, we are the winners. I don't know what else to say after that. And no one's gone. No one buys the dust. Hey, they're gonna get you too. Unless you've just celebrated 10 years. But once you get 10 years, you know, the writing's on the wall. It's not as good as it used to be. It's past its golden, age.
Retirement.
So. Retirement is looming for all of us. All that's going to be left is Emerald Coast. Emerald Coast is going to be the entire. Emerald Coast is going to rise up and destroy everybody. Except SonicOnline.fr. They'll be the only other survivors, but they'll be hiding somewhere. Under a rock. Broadcasting their pirate Sonic news in French. That's what they're going to do. I do want to just say, go on the Ethereal Online Forum, which is the Sonic Rix Forum. I'm glad you go there, because obviously you all do.
Actually,
there's a fair few of them doing Venice. Rex is still doing it, being a little slow. Who is that?
Hello.
I'm immediately worried who that is. It's somebody called Epic Hamsters. We've got a new member called Epic Hamsters on Eon. which is, you know, awesome. Who are you? I've never come across you before.
Yeah, that's deleted. Post 4.
What's going on to break this?
Alright, I'll mess around with it because I don't want anything popping up.
Yeah,
I'll be right back.
You'll be right back. Yeah, what's going on with that to destroy it? Yeah, Jay, I don't know what they've done, but they've just completely broken the table to the point of destruction. So whoever this is, they need to disappear. Sorry, I'm being distracted by this thing, which is really annoying me. Although it's just corrected itself, so I'm not sure. Who is this BQ Yayo rah rah rahs? User's posts. Yeah, they need to disappear. And hopefully, Blake Draco will sort that out for us. But when we haven't got really strange people posting, we do actually have strange people posting. Very, very artistic, creative people in Eon. You're all welcome. And they did actually. There was some questions there. Some people had indeed done some questions. Yay! So we've got some questions. In fact, we have two. In fact, we have one, because one of the comments is just, lol, what? Tanaku says, listen, do you smell that? Do you smell the ability to listen? No, I don't, actually. Unfortunately, I'm sure it would be a fantastic piece of stuff. Dragon's Den's on hiatus, and Blake Draco has a new headset or something. When did Blake Draco require a new headset? He's got a headset ages ago. He's a fail. He's sick. Ram, get on his ass about that. Because that is just fail. He says, will do, in big capital letters. Ram needs to turn off her caps lock. Seriously, severe, turn it off. Going on to, T-Bird says, spiders like spouts, or not really, as they get washed down them. But what can go up a spout, and what can go up a spout down, but can't go down the spout up? We fixed. Yeah.
Spam.
Spam, spam, spam. It wasn't really that much, but there was just like really weird tags that was making it really slow.
Yeah, it had.
What can go up a spout down, but can't go down a spout up? Is that tea? The teapot, by any chance? I'm trying to think of this. Up a spout down, but can't go down a spout up. Because you can go... when you pour tea out of a teapot, or goes up the spout, but you're holding it down. So I'm assuming it's that. T-Bird, let me know the answer to your riddle.
That is quite a good riddle.
Yeah, let me know the answer to your riddle, if I'm right or not right. I might be, can I get washed down them? It's probably difficult to wash tea down the spout into a teapot. Although it's not necessarily impossible. But then you need another device to pour it down. And it goes all over your hand, and you burn yourself, and then you drop the teapot. and then it lands shatters. On your foot and it shatters and you scald your foot as well. So Dark Overlord has added an L. No, he hasn't added an L. Craziness. It's rebellion. The answer is an umbrella, none of which feature in any Gary Oldman films. I'm talking about a water spout. Why would you go around sticking an umbrella up a water spout?
For comical reasons.
For comical reasons. Apparently, umbrellas don't feature in Gary Oldman films.
I don't know.
Yeah, so you're saying that in Batman there has never been an instance of an umbrella?
Penguin?
Not yet.
No?
not in the Gary Oldman ones, where he's that. No. Yeah, those umbrellas. There are many umbrellas. Umbrellas. Umbrella-rella-rellas. Actually, that's a good idea. Let's have umbrella. Let's have somebody who's familiar to you all sing it. Because one of the questions require a lot of explanation, probably. So I'm just going to prep that and move back to you very, very shortly.
Apart, maybe in magazines, but you still be my star, baby. Cause in the dark, you can't see shiny cars, and that's when you need me there. With you, I'll always share. Because when the sunshine will shine together, I told you I'd be here forever. I said I'll always be your friend. I'ma stick it out till the end. And now that it's raining more than ever, know that we'll still have each other. You can stand under my umbrella. You can stand under my umbrella. Under my umbrella. These fancy things will never come in between. You're part of my entity, here for infinity. When the war has took its part, when the world has dealt its cards, if the hand is hard, together we'll mend your heart. Because when the sunshine will shine together, I told you I'd be here forever. I'll always be your friend. Took an oath, I'ma stick it out till the end. And now that it's raining more than ever, know that we'll still have each other. You can stand under my umbrella. You can stand under my. You can run into my arms. That's okay, don't be alarmed. Come into me. Come in. Be all you need and more. Cause when the sunshine will shine together, I told you I'd be here forever. I said I'll always be your friend. Took an oath, now I'ma stick it out till the end. And now that it's raining more than ever, know that we'll still have each other. You can stand under my umbrella. You can stand under my umbrella.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah, it sounded pretty good. Cool. Hey, this is Bentley Jones, and you're listening to Archangel UK here on Radio Redux.
Indeed you are. Mm-hmm. Like I said, I'm guessing this show doesn't directly relate to Sega songs. It can do.
This is one of the great thing is about radio. It can be about pretty much anything, including a master race, I suppose. Hogfather asks, do you like my drawing of Spider Big? This could be hideous or wonderful. And I reserve judgment on what it is. Spider Big looks like he's sat on something sharp, according to this. This is scary.
Power saw.
Yes, it is most definitely a drawing, Hogfather. Mija says, what are your favourite alcoholic drinks? Well, this is going to be easy because Blake doesn't drink. I quite like a nice cold Budweiser. That's mine.
That's it, really?
That's all that can be said. VG says, does this make Emerald Coast fourth generation? Because I'm only about a year or two behind you. Yeah, you're fourth gen.
Fourth generation Emerald Coast.
Indeed, you're fourth gen. He was like, woo! That means you're in the same generation as me. Back in my day, we did Sonic Size properly. Johnny says, why? Why does the SMB hate him?
Probably, yeah.
Because all you do is post why, maybe. Max's Iron Brew and Plus Pepsi, what, together?
I haven't actually done that yet. I was going to.
You could do that, because Blake is a fan of both Iron Brew and Pepsi.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a funny feeling he'll be drinking Iron Brew and Pepsi at some point in the near future.
Might explode in my face at one point, but whatever.
If the Iron Brew plus Dr. Pepper might end the world.
Mm-hmm.
Blondie Light says, I'll give you to the end of the show to remember me, but I'm kind of impressed if you do guess. And then go on and give us a clue, but we've already deduced it's Earth Art, so. Silver Sonic says, in your opinion, if Crush 40 would do a music video for any of their songs, which one would it be? The one that doesn't cost me money for them to do it. No, actually. Let's have a look. Their songs. I Am All of Me would be good. Oh, it would be more likely to be one of their non-Sonic ones. You'd have thought.
Yeah, it's pretty much likely to be that.
Maybe Revving Up. Maybe Revving Up is a possibility. I don't know. Who knows? Max says I wouldn't say mix it. Oh, but you've given us a suggestion now. This has to be explored by somebody who likes both those things a lot, so that's going to be great.
Yeah, I don't know.
This is quite interesting seeing everyone like start to form. Blondie Lights, who is Earth Art, says, well, how do you guess? I'm not going to tell you. You have to tell us. You have to. Now that we've deduced who you are, you have to deduce how we know. I'm going to say Revving Up would be an awesome one. Ruby the Fox says, what are your thoughts on this OVA? Well, you may know what I'm going to say, but I know.
I really have.
I know
no
what you're going to say. Strange, isn't it? I don't know. It's one of those things that I actually couldn't care less about. The OVA. I don't know. It's its own little continuity all of itself, isn't it? Bit over the top and silly. It's one of those things that actually it's a bit too silly. that yes, we know Tails ropes a girl. Yes, we know Sonic gives the finger. Yes, we know Sonic sounds like an absolute moron. Eggman's weird. Metal Sonic is just stands there. Whoever stands there with going, ooh, I have power. Or he just goes, rah, I'm going to kill you in a sort of weird way. And then that falls as a girl. Actually, something I was thinking about the other day was, speaking of girls, let's see at least. You know, everyone has a massive go about the fact that Sonic, you know, kissed a girl. This is long before Kate Perry's advertising this fact being absolutely okay, though. People seem to forget that Sonic 06, at this point in time, he was dead! And to be honest, it wasn't like Sonic could go, oh no, get off, because he was dead! He was dead or next to dead. It's rather than to fend somebody off if you're dead. So it's not like he had much choice in the matter. He might have well gone thank you at least, but apart from that, was there any really real like look on his face afterwards? Apart from sort of just like, had a horror, and he went, thank you, Elise. But if you look at his eyes, it could have quite easily been the expression of somebody who was mortified. So, so not only do we bear in mind that Sonic has obviously never existed because it was written out of existence, but everyone's got to criticise Sonic for kissing the girl, and the girl kissed Sonic whilst he was dead. So, please bear in mind that it wasn't exactly consensual. In fact, you could call it statutory rape. His way. Nicking out the box. It's about at least having some sort of life goal. Make out a corpse. Do a tick box. But it's got like very, it's got loads of ticks and tick boxes. Behave like an animal with an animal. I But seriously, oh, it's like a kiss to go. No, we didn't! Do you even pay attention to these things? No, of course not. Slick fans and gamers, they don't pay attention to bloody anything. Oh, got a catch up on the chat. Earthfire has returned.
Earthfire has returned mysteriously.
The mysterious Earthfire has returned. And there's nothing's going on, basically, in this like, stadium chat. No one's listening. So it doesn't really matter. We can say whatever we like, because like, stadium sucks. It's a pile of dren. Everybody says I refuse to complete Sonic 06. I have no patience left for it. Oh, you know you had patience, but by the time it finished loading, it stopped. Everybody says, yeah, Sonic even stopped you down. Okay. Yeah. What's it ever done for us? I mean, really, what's it ever done for us? Alright, I'm the dragon. I've never come across her before. What's her name? If a Blake fangirl is in the woods but there's no Blake there, does she still make a sound? There is an answer to this, but that depends on whether or not this show is PG rated. It depends whether or not the fangirl is thinking about Blake and then realizing that there's no one in the woods and they're alone. And then there could be lots of sound, or potentially there could be just none at all. There could be it could either be the sigh of disappointment, or it could be, you know, something else.
No one would hear it though, because there's no one around.
But it would still make a sound, maybe. I don't know. Could be a bit. So just time out. Turbo post for the first time in God knows how long. who cares?
Yeah.
Who cares this show? You know, it's about whatever. It's past 8 o'clock. It's
a croc.
It's a croc. load of crock. Screw it. Does she still make a sound? Yes, it's pining. Well, the way the water is 9 p.m. but it's 9 p.m. somewhere in the world.
It's 9 p.m. in
many places. Shane Fox 04 though says, when we receive info on Rex Factor, and you will see, you receive it now. Wasn't planning to, but we might as well. Okay, so as of this moment, from the time you hear the words, I don't know, doctor, then Rex Factor's open.
Doctor!
There you go, so it's officially open. And, yeah, Rex Factor this year. Rex Factor, what year is this for Rex Factor? I've got, is it fourth year? Fourth year for Rex Factor. If you're not familiar with what Rex Factor is, you've obviously not been to a Summer of Sonic, not listened to a radio show from Radio Rex before, and not been on Sonic Rex ever. So on the basis that that makes you another like 85% of the fan base, I'll explain it again anyway. Rex Factor is the official... Well, if Radio Rex has somehow become this official Sega correspondence on the basis that somebody decided, somebody somewhere in the forum decided that Radio Rex is official, so that apparently must make it true, which must officially then make Rex Factor the official Sega karaoke competition, which it isn't, it's just the official Sonic Rex one. We do a little competition, you submit a song, we play it, we get some people to review it. And at the end of the day, all you have to look forward to is some people making either marvellous music or an utter fool out of themselves. And speaking of utter fools out of themselves, two of the people who've come last in the All Stars are actually in the chat room presently for Sonic Stadium.
So. Didn't technically make a fool of
himself. It's the most requested song on Rex Factor ever.
It's a cult classic.
It is a cult classic. Hence, we still have sound effects just for that song on the soundboard. It is quite impressive. But anyway, we have there's the All Stars and the All Comers. The All Comers is like the general fans, the rank and file, shall we say. Fans, mm-hmm. And whereas the All-Star ones, they're either people who have been in the Rex Factor before,
who have won
the All-Comers, or won the All-Stars. They're people who you know. They're normally like the main fans, and there's a couple of other sort of special situations as well. I mean, you could be a Sonic Rex staff member and stuff like that. Yeah, they're the All Stars, and they have like they have an extra judge who's normally some sort of celebrity or some vague famous connection. Previous judges have included Sega, which is pretty famous. I've certainly heard of that. Have you?
What?
Sega.
Ah, Sega.
I think they were a video company once.
I don't remember.
Didn't they die when the Dreamcast ended?
I thought that was the end of the 90s.
It was the end of the 90s, was it? No, whatever. Rory says, what as Kev said, I can't listen due to no headphones and being in a room where Pete's be watching TV. Just tell him I admitted I was gay and then snogs Blake for the next 5 minutes or something. Just say whatever. Just
make
freak him out.
Up.
Make crap up. semi also spoiled about 5 Sonic games and many things, and I announced a takeover of Sonic Stadium, and I fired Sven and anything else. Just start keep making up crap for the rest of the show. Ramp is going on about it. But yeah, so Rex Factor.
Nothing to cap,
I actually announced on Sonic 5 Episode 2. Which, and it's all upside down. It's all upside down, and the gravity is about 12G. so it squashes you. You just walk around like, a Half-Life Episode 3, I announce, contains Sonic, that's awesome, Ram. Oh, dear.
Enough of the caps there, please.
OMG, I know, yeah. Jeff Fox says gravity is 12 times. I thought G was a standard, you know, atmosphere based upon Earth atmosphere.
12 grams, I think, yeah.
12 grams. It's basically, our entire atmosphere, I've announced that our entire atmosphere has been replaced by a 1 kilogram bag of sugar. That's all that's protecting us from the sun. It's a big, massive bag of Tate and Lyle
up in the sky. It wouldn't be a bag of Tate and Lyle anymore. It'd be more syrup.
Ooh, golden spoon. Golden spoon?
Golden spoon.
Silver spoon.
Silver spoon, yes.
Yeah, silver. But yeah, I upgraded it. I like how everyone's now quoting to me gravity. I don't care! It's a joke.
T-Bird's gonna slap you.
T-Bird's gonna slap me. What? Just for that? He's gonna slap me with rocks, apparently. Anyway, so Rex Factor. There's normally a rule.
That's come back.
It's come back, but the popcorn has no mass.
Yeah.
Oh, I have to tell you this. There are a couple of awesome lines, actually, from the person who isn't here. And for some, we were having a talk the other day about the guy who plays Kane in Command and Conquer. And in reality, his other job is
a blackjack dealer.
He's a blackjack dealer. He does that. But this was being explained to me by Echo, and instead of going for some reason he is a blackjack dealer, she randomly said he is Jack Black's dealer. And it took a few moments to realise what the hell did he just say. It was like Cain of Command & Conquer is Jack Black's dealer. This was scandalous information. So the Supreme One is busy, you know. That's why he's not there half the time. He's been Nod. He's busy. He's been turning up at the back and at the stage entrance to Sedacious D concerts. Yeah. With a big trench coat on, opening it, and there's being vast arrays of pills and syringes. and sprays.
We're gonna have a segment that she won't
hear. Oh, what was the other? What was the
segment there? Was the American view on English history.
Oh, that was awesome.
It's like Indians got
Indian Civil War was it?
No, Indian Independence.
Indian Independence was like, well, they had a bit of a bar there or something. that was her summary. Well, they didn't quite get on. And then it was fine. Tim said, I like putting the cheat in and watching him give a video resume. Can't conquer the PC. Oh, I don't know. But yeah. So, we are now opening for Rex Factor entries. There's normally a rule. Last year was the Dark Speeds rule. In that, the gimmick, if you like. Oh my god, Rex Factor had gimmicks. Was that the song had. The All-Stars have just come up with their own lyrics, basically. They didn't have to, but it was certainly suggested that was probably the case. And then, so we gave it the Dark Speeds rule because Dark Speeds was always doing that, and then Dark Speeds promptly didn't show up that year. So this year, lyrics got you more points. This year, we're extending it a bit. You don't have to be in before Christmas. But what you do have to be have your song in by is like first or second week of January. So I'm actually extending it this year because we had loads of problems last year. on the lawn.
Oh dear, someone's ripping off my other poses and things. Okay, oh well. Can't be helped.
You'll get that.
Yeah, so this year is, well, All Stars, there's going to be like two things. You can get extra bonus points if you make your own music. We've been building up to this for 4 years. It was like other languages and, you know, write your own lyrics. And now it's like, if you write your own music and do it, you'll get oodles of bonus points. However, All Stars have to sort of... I heard noise from above.
Hmm.
The beast might be stirring. Dun, dun, dun. But All Stars, and you will know who you are if you are entering this year. I am going to give you a very special task. In that I am... I was going to make it like I chose your song. But what you have to do is going to sing one song to a tune of another. So, you got to figure this, all right? You got to sort of rework the words of another Sonic song into the music of another song. So this could be like singing His World to Amy's Theme or something. So you got to think and do some work here.
You're better off looking for ones that are similar. I think similar music composition.
So yeah, obviously, if I find out that somebody has done the words to "It Doesn't Matter" Sonic Adventure 1 to the music from "It Doesn't Matter" Sonic Adventure 2, that's not going to count. So. That's your task this year. So it could be pretty much anything. But get creative. Get creative with the old lyrics. If you specifically want me, All Stars, to pick you a song, but that we'll do that as well then. And if you have a song, if you want me to pick a specific song for you to do, then we'll do that. You don't have to do that, but I'll be taking note of those people who have.
Those who received the bonus marks, you mean?
Retrix says, excellent, it's the I'm sorry I haven't a clue Rex Factor. Damn straight it is. See, it's not absolutely law. So if you were planning to do something, like I know Earth Art was planning to do something, then he's perfectly able to do. But yeah, it is the equivalent of singing, you know, I Am All of Me to Sweet, Sweet, Sweet. And making it work. So obviously you can tweak lyrics a bit. So if you somehow manage to do that, the words of one to the instrumental of another, and maybe like in another language, then you'll think like monstrous bonus mark. So it's gonna be a bit of fun. This is, I think, if you have a little think about it, there'll be a few combinations that you could think would be quite good. It's a bit of a mashup, basically. Challenge accepted, Mr. Eva, says Ram the Dragon. Good. So yeah, it's now open. Go nuts. All comers don't have to do any of that nonsense. Just have some fun in it. This is, yeah, people saying, oh, I'm not sure what the song is, I'm thinking up a good one. That's why you're getting extra time. Because it also means if you can do extra singing and stuff, or if you'll do some extra music or whatever. And Earthart's actually, Earthart is covering Yano. That's his entry this year. Which is actually the music from it's the Radio Redux theme. He's doing that. But yeah, if you can put in a duet, there's bonus marks, Don't get the bonus marks for if you do your own music, you get your own bonus marks. If you do your own lyrics, you get bonus marks. If you do a duet, you get bonus marks. And if you sing the song in another language, you get bonus marks. Another language that the song hasn't been done in, officially. But yeah, that's it. We have any more questions? I should ask the Shadow Fox's question. But yeah, it's open now. that's pretty much it, actually, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think. Shall we have some music to end?
Yeah, why not?
Actually, I'm going to end with... I'm going to end the show, officially. And then I'm going to play, like, one song to a tune of another from I'm Sorry, Having a Clue. So people get an idea. But, yeah, so that'll just be a bit of comedy stuff for the end of the show. Doesn't matter. Nick Governato says, what if someone did a duet with one singing, let's say, in Japanese, the other singing in German? A, that would probably sound terrible. Because they both languages, their speed and their natural flow is very different, I would say. So,
yeah, you're going to get that.
If you get a whole, if you manage to get a whole choir to sing it, as maybe the Fox just said, that would be awesome.
Just hire them.
Rory says, I think the last time I heard a Rex Factor injury someone, I was prompted to draw something slagging it off. let's have a Rex Factor, one of the good Rex Factor ones. Ba-ba-bum, ba-ba-ba-bum. I'm trying to find a decent one now. I could play Me and My Shadow again from Darkspeed's Nerf Art, because Nerf Art hates it when I play it. Really,
just
really.
Just to spite him.
He really does. I'm going to play Live Life in Spanish by Iris and Me and My Shadow to end the show. Because... I mean, this first, the Me and My Shadow, which is going to come up first, is it didn't even, it was just one they did for fun, which I think is awesome. If you do like extra ones, or if you do like a song that you don't want to enter, but you know, or if you even had like some sort of work in progress versions or a version you didn't think was very good, yeah, send it in, because we tend to put them on. We put all the MP3s up as like a special. The downloadable album, and we actually put those on there as like bonus tracks that people haven't heard. So if you've got, if you want to submit more than one and then sort of say that, okay, but this one is my actual entry, that's awesome, we'll have them and put them up for you. Okay, so we're gonna have this Dark Speaks Nerf Up, Me and My Shadow, Iris All Stars Live Life, then it's gonna be the end. Oh Christ, Nerf Up saying you are cruel.
Well,
you were heartless, so...
shouldn't care.
So you shouldn't care, no. So what we're going to have is that... then the show's going to end, but then I'm going to play you about 5 minutes of, like, comedy stuff anyway.
Ha-ha.
Which is actually from I'm Sorry, Having a Clue Live. Where are we? Anyway, okay. So, yeah, end of the show. I've been Archange UK.
I've been Blink Draco.
And we will see you next week for our special Halloween show. And which is spookily going to be the 31st show of the series on the 31st of October.
That's quite interesting.
And completely not deliberate. It wasn't done like that at all. Anyway.
We will see you next week, laden with ghosts and ghoulies and bobbing for apples, but hopefully not the apples that are out there at the moment, because they're probably rotten.
I threw them away.
You threw them away. That was very good of you.
Bobbing for pears.
Bobbing for pears. But you'll drown. Exactly. I remember QI. I'm
not doing it, though. Yeah. I'm not bobbing. Yeah. Anyone else can.
We can discuss this later. Yeah. We'll see you next week, okay? We'll see you next week. Here's the music.
Hard and dark speeds.
That isn't an accent.
I know, but I can't stop here, Pally.
No, let's just get on.
Like the wallpaper sticks to the wall.
And like the sea shark clings to the sea.
Like you'll never get rid of your shadow.
You'll never get rid of me.
Let all the others fight and fuss. Whatever happens, we've got it all.
Me.
Closer than pages that stick
and
in a book. We're closer than ripples that flow in a brook. Wherever you'll find him, you'll find me, just look. Closer than eyes are all the bloodhounds turn eyes on me.
Closer to smog is to all of this town. Closer to Snively confessing he's gay. Not a soul can bust this team in two. We stick together like glue. And when it's sleeping time,
that's when we rise.
We start to swing.
You think you're suave, don't you?
Clocks don't chime.
What a surprise.
They ring,
a ding ding, happy new year, me.
And not to repeat what I said
and
at the start. No need a logical bar to break us apart.
We're a love but far from blue.
Okay, you're way too good at this.
Before we get finished, we'll make the town roar. We'll hit a few late spots and then a few more.
We'll start out as string keys and maybe crunch your life. It's gonna be a wild, wild week. Oh my, shadow and me.
Yeah!
Come on, let's do this one more time.
What?
Before we can finish, we'll make the town roar. We'll hit a few late spots and then a few more.
We'll start out as drinkies and maybe crouch your line. It's gonna be a wild, wild week for my shadow and me.
Radio Redux.